wish y'all would just help me just for a minute. Here they, God has just delivered them, just brought them out, and now here they are in the middle of the desert, and they're missing something as simple as water. And the Bible says that they started complaining. They started grumbling. They started complaining. And I need to point something out to you. If you read your Bible, you'll discover that this was right after worship. If you read right before what happens, what we read, they had just finished praising God.
Moses cried to God, and God responded.
You ain't feeling it.
Yeah, come on.
If they were really thinking, all they really had to do was do a little bit of reflection. Just reflect a little bit, and they would have remembered not too long ago in Exodus chapter 3, for those of you who want to check me out, make sure I ain't making it up. In Exodus chapter number 3, the Bible says they were still in captivity, but God said, I have heard your cry. And so God sent them Moses because they were crying to him, but God did nothing when they were complaining. And I just need to let somebody know this morning that somebody needs to change your attitude on life. Because I discovered something. God does nothing as long as we're grumbling and complaining. I know I'm right about it. Read your Bible, you'll discover every time the children of Israel complained, there was devastation. Every time they complained, there was heartache and misery. But the second they cried out to God, and it was just like Pastor Jackson said, no matter who you are, where you've been, or what you've done, God loves you. It didn't matter how sinful they were. Whenever they cried out to God, God responded to them. And I just needed to let somebody here know today, thank you, Holy Ghost, that God told me to tell you, it doesn't matter what you've been involved in, if you can just stop complaining and start crying out to God and letting God know, God, I need you. I can't make it without you. I know life ain't the way I want it to be, but thank you for where I am right now. Somebody can testify if you cry out to God. Why I like the way our ancestors used to worship. Because you didn't go to church Sunday after Sunday and never hear somebody at least just say, Lord, have mercy. Every now and then, the best thing to do is just say, Lord, have mercy. Because in a very real sense, if God were to allow the consequences of everything that we've done to come up on us, stuff would be a lot worse than it is right now. So thank you, God. I ain't going to complain anymore. Thank you for everything that you've done. Insult whenever we complain against God. I tell my children one time, my son asked me, got a little late, I got busy, and my son asked me something one time, and it almost made me hurt. He said, we gonna eat. I had to check the calendar. I said, man, has there ever been a day you didn't eat? Then why would you insult me by asking me something like that because I'm a little later than I was every other day? Help me, somebody. And God, as I was walking away, I started to get him. God said, wait a minute, Chris. I got to do the same thing to you. You've been complaining about some stuff and wondering where I was, but you guys need to think back. Has there ever been a time that I left you hanging? And I said, no, you never left me hanging. Just change my locality. I can change my mentality. You were thinking if I could just move, if I can get away from where I am right now, things would be better. But I came by to let you know, baby, God don't have to change where you are. God can change who you are, where you are, and what you're going through won't be the same. I know I got some witnesses in here. God didn't move them from Moriah. The Bible said God told them, listen, if you would just put the right stuff in your situation. What we read, the Bible says that Moses cried out to God and God showed Moses a tree. Now can't no preacher look at that and just pass by, no more.